Good evening.
Good evening, teacher.
How are you today, Jorge?
It's fine, teacher.
Okay, nice. I'm glad to hear that.
Yeah.
Everybody asleep, right? Okay.
It's raining, teacher. It's raining.
Yeah, it's raining a lot, so that's true. Yeah, I know, don't worry.
Okay, teacher.
Yeah, what about you? Did you work today?
Yes, I work every day.
Ah, really?
Only I work in my house.
Okay. Okay, that's much better, right? Okay, really good, Jorge. Because of the time, I don't know if you have questions about yesterday's class. Okay, good evening, Fabrizio. How are you?
Good evening, teacher. I'm fine, thanks.
Okay, really good. Okay, we are about to start with today's class in a minute.
Okay, no problem.
Okay, good. Nice. Okay, I'm gonna wait for the rest of the students. Jorge, you work at the bank, right?
What?
Do you work at the bank?
Yes, teacher.
Okay, nice.
In the Banco de Fomento Agropecuario.
Yeah, BFA.
Yes.
Yeah, sure. That's the best bank. Okay, cool. What about you, Fabrizio? Where do you work?
En Boteadora La Cascada. Oh. Making soda.
Ah, really?
Soda, water, ¿cómo se llama? Isotónicos, de los energizantes,
jugo. ¿Con la champán?
La champán es el escudo.
Ah,
sí, esa es la que a todos les gusta.
Ah, yeah, sure.
Cuando llegan, como tienen bastante visita, los chapines, lo primero que piden es una cola champán.
Yeah, it's delicious, right?
It's delicious.
Okay, yes. Nice. Okay, good evening, Tatiana.
Good evening, teacher.
How are you?
Fine.
Okay, good. Glad to see you today. Good evening, Marvin.
Good evening, teacher. Good evening, Marvin.
Okay, cool. Okay, I'm gonna start with today's class because of the time, and right now we're gonna continue with unit number 3. Let me see. Okay. Yeah, sure, here we go. Okay, basically, we're gonna continue with unit number 3, customer service. And we are going to talk about the simple past yes, no question, right? We're gonna continue to talk about the simple past, but in this case, we're gonna go to yes, no questions. Vamos a ver básicamente las preguntas de sí y no en simple past. Okay, cool. Okay, I'm gonna start with lesson objectives. We get it this. Okay, I don't know, somebody help me to read the first one. Okay, go ahead, Fabrizio.
Okay. Lesson objectives, specific.
Okay.
Participant will be able to ask customer questions to confirm to they got that what was promised.
Okay, promised.
Promise.
Yeah, sure. Thank you. Really good. Okay, the second one, I don't know, somebody who wants to read it, a volunteer. Okay, Okay, go ahead, Marvin.
At the end of the class, participant will be able to know how to use interrogative, possibility, and negative of past tense.
Okay, yeah, sure, really good. Thank you, Marvin. Okay, basically, students, I'm gonna continue to talk about the past simple tense. But right now, we're gonna see interrogative, positive, and negative. In yesterday class, we practiced with some exercise that was nice. Some of you did it excellent. Some got a little problems, but we're gonna try to make a feedback because of that. Vamos a hacer un pequeño retroalimentación debido a eso. Okay, here we go. Let me see. Okay, good evening, Mary. Okay, how are you? Okay, really nice. I know that right now it's raining a lot.
Fine.
Okay, thank you, Mary. Sé que ahorita está lloviendo fuerte, muchísimo, así que vamos a tener un poquito de internet problem with the connection, right? Pero thanks for being here. Vamos a intentar aprender lo más que se pueda, right? Yep, sure. Okay, we're gonna make a feedback about yesterday class. And let me see. Yeah, sure. Okay. Basically, we got the past simples and we get a short meaning about the past simples. Tenemos un pequeño definición del pasado simple. Okay, Tatiana, can you help me to read this one?
Past simple. It's called
called con D al final. It's called call. Okay. Go ahead, Tatiana.
No?
Yeah.
Hay interferencia, teacher. No entiendo. I don't understand.
Okay, no problem. Okay, all right. Can you help me, Jorge?
Past simple. It's called list like this because we talk about something in the past in a very simple way.
Okay, yeah, really good. Thank you. Basically, students, past simples le llamamos así porque hablamos de algo en el pasado, pero en una manera muy simple, muy simple, in a simple way, right? Es decir, no decimos cosas muy estructuradas, sino que ayer comí, ¿qué? Una hamburguesa. Fui a trabajar. ¿Sí? Trabajé mucho ayer. Entonces, eso es pasado simple. Ok, muy bien. Veamos. But the past simples, we got some examples here. And the example that we're going to have is this. Vamos a entender por pasado simple el verbo to be, right? The verb be was and were. Entonces tenemos un ejemplo. Was and were significa en pasado fui o estuve, right? Yes? Okay. So in this case, we got this example. Fabricio, help me to read the first one, please.
She was here before. Okay. Simple past.
Yeah, sure. And the meaning in Spanish?
Ella estuvo acá después. Antes.
Okay. Yeah, sure. Pero... Okay, no problem. Ella estuvo aquí antes. O ella
antes.
Estaba aquí antes. Entonces, acá usamos verbo to be. ¿Hay otro verbo después? No, right?
No.
Verbo to be porque es pasado simple. Okay, now let's see another example. Okay, let me see, Marvin.
You were a doctor when you were young.
Okay, yeah, really good. And now try to translate into Spanish.
Where is... Como que tú fuiste al doctor. Cuando tú eres joven, algo así, teacher.
Ok, ok, muy bien, Morbi. Ahí está la clave. Veamos acá. Was y were significan lo mismo. Fui o estuve. Que es del pasado ser o estar, el presente. Entonces acá, she was here before. Ella estuvo aquí antes. Estuvo. You were a doctor. Tú. Ajá.
Tú fuiste un doctor cuando tú fuiste joven.
Yeah, really good. Thank you, Tatiana. Tú fuiste un doctor cuando tú fuiste o estabas joven. ¿Sí? Entonces notamos que este verbo to be en the past tense solo significa fue o estuvo. ¿Sí? Ok, pero no fue de ir. Vamos a confundir eso, porque ese fue es de ser o estar. El de ir es go. El pasado es went. ¿Ya? Ok, cool. Good evening, Fernando. Ok, nice to see you today. Ok, we're going to continue with the feedback, right? And right now we're gonna have some example here. Acá in this example, students, some of you got a problem with this. Algunos de ustedes tuvieron un pequeño problemita porque me hacían algo así. Por ejemplo, Tatiana, can you help me to read this? Okay, Fernando, go ahead. Thank you, Tatiana. Go ahead.
She was it here before.
Okay.
She was eating tortillas.
Okay.
She ate pupusas with my family.
Okay, really good. Thank you, Tatiana. Esta, Tatiana, esta, you're gonna say eight.
Okay. She ate pupusa with my family.
Yeah, sure. Okay, what's happened here, guys? Let's see. Algunos de ustedes me ponían was y después este it. En este caso, no tenía sentido porque estamos en un pasado simple. Sí se puede esa estructura, solo que sería así como esta. Esta se llama pasado continuo. ¿Sí? Es decir, ustedes no pueden decir ella estaba... comer aquí antes. No tendría sentido, ¿verdad? El sentido sería she was eating tortillas here before, for example. Ella estaba comiendo, ahí sí, agregamos ing. Pero ese es un pasado continuo. Y ahorita estamos en pasado simple. ¿Ya? Yep. Ok, la forma correcta sería sin el was. She ate pupusas with my family. Ella comió unas 10 pupusas con su familia, right? Like this. Ok, ¿se comprende esto? Yeah, sure. Ahí, like a Fernando, right? Pupusas right now. Ok, that's good.
Churritos.
Ah, churritos, ok.
I want churrito.
Ok, that's good. Entonces, esta, this is the wrong way. Esta es una forma errónea. Sí, sí se puede hacer, solo que sería este segundo verbo con ing, like this. ING, yep. Okay, the best way is eight. And we change or erase this word. Okay, very good. As you see, then we're gonna have irregular verbs. ¿Qué pasa con los verbos irregulares? Cambia su raíz. En el caso de it, cambia a ate. Ate. Por ejemplo, en unos 5 minutos, Fernando ya se habrá acabado su churrito. Entonces, él va a decir, teacher, I ate a churrito.
I ate.
Yeah, sure. Ya no vamos a decir it porque es en pasado. Ya se lo devoró, así que ni modo, right? Okay, good.
Teacher.
Yeah, sure.
Excuse me. Una pregunta. ¿Ella come pupusas con mi familia? ¿Así o her family?
Ah, yeah. Her
familia.
Sure. Yeah, you can say with her family. Puede ser su familia de ella. Pero en este caso, Tatiana, básicamente, hablando de mi familia, o sea, ella comió con mi familia. Pero sí puede ser.
Sí, dijo señorita en español.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Okay, let's see. Okay, give me a minute. Okay, good evening. How are you today, guys? Okay, let's see. We're gonna continue with this because of the time. Estábamos viendo el past simple. Teníamos el was y were. Las formas que no hay que hacer ese was y were y la forma correcta. Right? Luego teníamos irregular verbs que solo cambia su raíz de it a ate. Y then we're gonna have the irregular verbs. ¿Qué pasaba con los verbos regulares? Solo agregábamos ed. Yeah, sure. Y esa ed tenía unas 3 posibles pronunciaciones. It, t, y la d, que ni se escucha, pero así se pronuncia. Let's see a couple of examples here. We got the simple past, Marlon, Ernesto, can you help me to read it?
She drew a car last week.
Okay, thank you, really good. Marlon, can you translate it into Spanish?
Ella manejó un carro la semana pasada.
Okay, yeah, thank you, really good. Este drove es el pasado de drive, manejar. Entonces aquí es manejó, right? Okay, very good. Thank you, Marlon, that's cool. But right now, we're gonna see that we can say the same, but in the negative way. For example, Carlos Alfonso, help me to read this one.
Okay. She didn't drive a car last week.
Thank you. Now in Spanish.
Ella no manejó un carro la semana pasada.
Okay, yeah, really good. What happened here? El verbo cambia a su forma.
Original.
Original, yeah, sure. ¿Por qué? Porque estamos negando con.
Con did.
Con didn't. Él nos está diciendo que ya es pasado, así que no es necesario volverlo a poner. ¿Se comprende eso? Yes. Yeah. Okay, I don't know if you have a question about this. No questions? Okay, if you don't have questions, I got some questions for you. I'm just kidding, right? Okay, did not is an auxiliary in the past, right? Okay, here we go. Right now, we're gonna start with the attendance list. Unfortunately, vamos a pasar lista. Así que when you hear your name, say, present teacher, I'm here, right? I'm with a cup of coffee. And Fernando, I got some churros here, right? Okay. Okay, let me see. Okay, yeah, sure. Okay, in the team, right? Carlos Enrique Martinez. Hey, Carlos, all right. Okay, Wendy Saraí Bonilla Ordóñez.
I am here, teacher.
Yeah, really good, Wendy. Okay, José Ángel Santos Martínez. José Ángel, all right. Gabriela Merari Zamora Orellana.
Present, teacher.
Okay, really good, thank you. Jorge Alberto Ortiz Molina.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Okay, you got a 10. Carlos Alfonso Alvarado Hernández.
Present, teacher.
Hey, thank you. And Fernando de Jesús Roldán Torres.
Present. Ya me borraron de la lista.
Okay. I don't know why, right? Okay, ahí está en la lista. Gris, esta no es negra, esa es la lista gris ahí. Right?
Los que van a repetir.
Okay.
Cállate, Carlos.
Carlos Antonio Mejía Hernández.
Present, teacher.
Okay, thank you, Carlos. William Alexander Martínez.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Miguel Ángel Alexander López.
Present, teacher.
Okay, thank you. And right now, Marlon Ernesto Rodríguez Sandoval. Marlon Ernesto.
Present, teacher.
Rodrigo Alexander Maravilla Vázquez. And Daisy Elizabeth Recino Álvarez.
Present, teacher. I am here.
Thank you. Tatiana Yvonne Torres.
I am here, teacher.
Cool, nice. Marvin Ernesto Alfaro Campos.
Present, I am here.
Yeah, sure, really good. Carlos René Herrera.
Present, teacher.
Okay, nice. Fabricio Alexander Jiménez Herrera.
I'm here, teacher.
Okay, I'm really good. Okay, nice. Congratulations. Some of you no han faltado ni una sola vez. En el caso de Fabricio, congratulations, Fabricio. Okay, nice. I'm going to continue to take class because of the time. Okay, please. Let me see. Yeah, sure. Okay. Okay. Basically, we're going to continue to talk about the past tense, right? The past tense, we were talking about the verb be, was, and were. And then we got the auxiliary to. In the past, we're going to use did, right? Then the regular verbs, son los que le agregamos una ed. En irregular verbs, los que cambian totalmente. Ya habíamos visto este, 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 y ahora este. And right now, we're going to see the negative way too. Yep. Okay, here we go. Before to start with this, we got a couple of verbs in present and in the past, right? And we have to learn this verb. It's going to be really useful for you. Okay, here we go. We're going to have the first one. Carlos Mejía, can you read this one?
Hi, teacher.
Can you read this one? Okay, Carlos, can you read this one, the first verb? ¿Puede ayudarme a leer este, Carlos?
Escucha hoy.
Yeah, yeah, sure.
Okay. Que tengo problema con el micrófono, perdón.
Okay.
When.
Okay.
When did.
Okay, yeah, thank you. Want, wanted. Want, wanted.
Want, wanted.
Yeah, want significa. Okay, somebody who helped Carlos, alguien que le quiera ayudar.
Querer.
Querer.
Querer, ok, muy bien, querer, pero no de querer así de amor, right? Sino de querer alguna cosa de deseo. Por ejemplo, yo quiero un carro nuevo. I want a new car, but I don't have money, right? Pero no tengo ahí the money. Ok. El
préstamo Promérica.
Pero ahí tenemos un asesor. Ok, that's good. Wanted, estamos hablando de un pasado. Yo quise, por ejemplo, I wanted a bicycle, for example. Yo quería una bicicleta, pero en ese tiempo no pude comprarla, right? Entonces, en pasado, pasado simple, wanted. Ok, wanted. Really good. William, can you continue reading the verbs?
Fly. Fle.
Okay. Okay. Flew.
Flew.
Flew. Yes. Fly. Flew. Okay, really good. Listen to this. Fly. Flew. What does it mean, fly?
Volar.
Volar. ¿Y este?
Voló.
Voló, right? Voló. Ok, muy bien. Aquí no, es, no tiene nada que ver con cosas así.
Bebidas alcohólicas.
Ok, yeah, like this. Sino que es de volar, de la action, right? Like a bird. Puede ser en un avión o lo que sea. Que vuele. Ok, probablemente in our dreams, en nuestros sueños. Ahí utilizamos this verb, fly. Ok, flew. Volar, volé. Yeah, for example, I flew to Madrid last year. Un ejemplo, ¿verdad? Porque fue en mis sueños. Ok. Volé a Madrid el año pasado. Yep. In my dreams, of course. Ok. We're going to continue with this one. Let me see. Fabricio.
Sing.
This one?
Sing.
Ok, thank you. What is sing?
Cantar.
Cantar. ¿Y este qué?
Cantó.
Ok, muy bien. Ahí es algo básico, así que vamos a ir pasando. Thank you. Now, Wendy, can you help me with this?
It's a grow.
Ok.
And you.
Grew, yes, really good. Grow, grew, grew. This one, what does it mean?
Crecer.
Crecer, muy bien. ¿Y este qué?
Crecí, creció.
Creció, crecí. Por ejemplo, I grew up in Moncagua. Yo crecí en Moncagua. Acá le podemos agregar up, 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 right? Y significa lo mismo. Ok, really good. Thank you. Right now, we're going to go to Daisy. Go ahead, Daisy.
Hi.
Hello, Daisy. Can you help me to read this one?
No.
Yeah.
No.
Okay, this one is new.
New.
New, yes. Okay, thank you, Daisy. No, what does it mean, no?
No, no.
I know.
Saber, no.
Yeah, yeah. Saber, thank you. Saber o conocer. Por ejemplo, no. Teacher, I know that topic. Yo sé ese tema. También pueden decir, yo conozco a Carlos Mejía. I know Carlos Mejía. Un ejemplo, right? New. El pasado de conocer. New.
Sabía.
For example, si yo les digo, ¿ustedes sabían estos verbos? Yeah, teacher, I knew them. Ya me lo sabía, ya me los podía, right? New. Si ustedes notan, se dice de la misma forma que nuevo. New. La misma forma. Ok, really.
Please, okay.
Teacher, question.
Yeah, yeah.
¿Cómo vamos a diferenciar, por ejemplo, new? Es casi también parecido cuando decimos ahora.
Oh, that's now.
Ajá.
Now.
Se pronuncia now.
Now, yes.
Okay.
Now, yeah. Okay, cool. Right now we're gonna go. Thank you, Fernando. Now help me with this.
Sleep.
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 Okay. Sleep.
Yes, sleep.
Slept.
Slept.
Okay, I would like to give you some tips with the pronunciation of these verbs. And basically, esta S se pronuncia en inglés como una S, no con ES. Por ejemplo, ustedes dicen sleep, sleep. ¿Sí? No podemos decir sleep, sino que es sleep, sleep.
Sleep. Sleep.
Y esta sería slept.
Slept.
Yeah. For example, yeah, este verbo es de los más hermosos que hay, ya lo habíamos mencionado antes. Así que es muy útil que ustedes lo manejen. For example, teacher.
Sleep in the class.
Yeah, sure, I said your class. Que solo se a ti,
sorry.
Okay, that's good. For example, we got did it, this one. I knew it. Esto es algo muy útil en English. I knew it. Es.
Yo conozco.
Yo sabía esto.
Lo sabía.
Okay. Lo sabía. Lo sabía. I knew it. Lo sabía. Ya estamos hablando del pasado. Es una expresión sumamente útil. Así que si no, si you don't know. Y si ya la sabían, pues. Okay. You knew it, right? Okay, cool. Do you have a question about this? No? Okay, I would like to...
Sorry, teacher.
Yeah.
No entendí la diferencia entre new, de haber conocido, y de nuevo. No entendí, perdón.
Okay. Veamos acá. Thank you, Carlos. Let's see here. For example, we got it this.
Este,
vamos a tener cuidado porque este es nuevo y este es noticias, news.
News.
News. Entonces, ¿cuál va a ser la diferencia entre estos dos? Vamos a empezar con esto. I have a new car. I have a new car. Tengo un carro nuevo, que es mentira, ¿verdad? Pero es un ejemplo ahí. Ok. Usted dice I read the newspaper. Okay, you see here the difference. I have a new car. I read the news in the newspaper. Yo leí las noticias en el periódico. Este leí, como es en pasado, vamos a leerlo como read. Y la expresión esta es en presente, sería read. Ok. Ahora vamos a... I'm gonna jump to the verb. You, this one. You can say it like this. I knew that news. Okay, this is gonna sound like a tongue twist, right? Va a sonar como un trabalengua, pero ni modo. I knew that news. ¿Sabía?
Yeah. Yo sé estas noticias.
In the past tense, Tatiana.
Yo sabía esa noticia.
I knew that news. ¿Sí? Entonces, si ustedes notan, new es una palabra diferente, aunque se pronuncia igual. New en new. ¿Qué nos va a decir que es un verbo? El contexto. Y acá el contexto. Acá estamos hablando de un nuevo carro, una nueva bicicleta, a new motorcycle, a new jet ski, lo que sea que a ustedes les encante, right? Okay, Carlos, it's clear?
Okay. Thank you, teacher.
Okay, you're welcome. Pretty good. Okay, we're gonna continue with this. This one, want, wanted. Fly, flew. Sing, sang. Esta G se tiene que escuchar. Sing, sang. Grow, grew. Know, knew. Sleep, slept. Okay, it's clear, right? Okay, si está claro, vamos a ver si es cierto. Veamos, let me see, William, dígamelos todos, please.
Okay.
Okay, go ahead.
Want, want. Want.
Okay, William, want, wanted.
Ah, want, wanted.
Yeah.
Fly, flew.
Okay.
Sing, sang.
Yeah.
Grew, grew.
La primera está bien, pero la primera es esta. Grew, grew. Grow.
Grow, grew, es cierto.
Yeah, sure. Okay.
Now, new.
Yeah.
Sleep. Sleep.
Okay, yeah, really good, nice. Hasta una canción de fondo le pusieron ahí de reggaeton, William. That's amazing. Really, really good. Okay.
The television.
Ah, the TV, right? Okay, okay, that's amazing. A problem with this pronunciation? You don't have any problem? No. Yes. Let me know. I'm going to be here for you. ¿Estamos clear?
Everything is clear.
Okay, that's good. Everything is clear like a cola champagne, right, Fabrizio? the best product of the company Cascada. I really like cola champagne. It's good. Okay, nice. Okay, we're gonna continue with this because of the time. And right now, we're gonna see the negative wave of the past be and the simple past. Let's see this. This is gonna be a little bit boring, but we have to do it. ¿Qué vamos a hacer acá? Yo voy a seleccionar un nombre de ustedes. Tienen que estar atentos. Lo voy a decir en inglés y ustedes en español. Luego ustedes lo van a decirme otro en inglés y yo en español, right? Okay, here we go. The past be se dice wasn't or weren't. También pueden decirlo was not or were not. For example, Miguel, I wasn't interested.
No estaba interesado.
Yeah, really good. Ahora, Miguel, say this one in English.
You weren't called.
Okay. Tú no estabas helado ahí. No tenía frío, por decirlo así.
Estaba frío.
Yeah, yeah, like a weather, right? Today. Okay, that's good. I'm going to continue with this. Let me see. Marvin, he wasn't kind. Okay, what does it mean in Spanish?
Kind.
Kind es amable.
Es amable. Él no estaba, él no era amable.
Yeah, él no era amable. Really good. Now, say this one in English.
The people weren't helpful.
Helpful. Really good. Thank you, Marvin. Jorge, can you translate this one into Spanish?
La gente no era colaboradora o ayuda.
Yeah, sure. Yeah, really good. La gente no era colaboradora. Nice. Now, Jorge, say this one in English.
They weren't online.
Yeah, sure. Thank you. Carlos René Herrera, can you translate it to Spanish?
Ellos no estaban en línea.
Yeah, sure. Really good. Okay, Carlos, say this one in English.
I didn't receive any number.
Okay, very good. Fernando, translate it into Spanish.
No recibí varios números o algunos números. No recibí números.
Yeah. Now say this one in English.
I didn't send a contract.
Okay, you. Say this one again.
You did send a contract.
Okay, you didn't send
a contract.
Okay, yeah, really good. Thank you, Fernando. Daisy, translate it, please.
You did send a contract.
Uh-huh. What does it mean in Spanish?
Tú no enviaste el contrato, un contrato.
Yeah, sure, really good. Right now, they see, say this one in English.
He didn't say his name.
Okay, thank you.
Él no dijo su nombre.
Okay, really good.
Say his name.
He didn't say his name. Really good. Él no dijo su nombre. Muy bien.
I didn't say his
name. Okay.
She didn't call again.
Yep.
Ella no llamó de nuevo.
Uh-huh. Thank you, Daisy. Really good. And the last one, help me, Marlon.
Okay.
Okay, Marlon, are you there?
Okay, teacher, we didn't buy a product. Uh-huh. Nosotros no compramos un producto.
Okay, yeah, really good. As you see, students, thank you, Marlon. We're gonna add just not. Vamos a agregar solo not. Y contractado se dice wasn't, weren't, didn't. Okay. You got this, right? ¿Se entiende eso? Yeah.
Yes.
Okay, questions? No questions?
Teacher, question.
Tell me, Marvin.
El was es para primeras personas y el weren't es para... No, perdón, el wasn't es para primeras personas.
Okay.
El weren't es para terceras.
Yeah, sure. Okay, Marvin, I'm sorry. I'm going to show you something like this. Okay. Acá. Let's see. Tenemos the personal pronouns. I, she, he, and it. Estas son terceras personas. Esta es number one, right? Ok, para esto se va a utilizar was. Yep. Y para los plurales, you, they, and we, vamos a utilizar were. Yep. Like this. Ok. Really good. Ok, we're going to continue with this.
Thanks, teacher.
Ok, you're welcome. And we're gonna have an activity, right?
Teacher, question.
Tell me, Wendy.
Didn't usual in the person or product? Or cosas?
Okay, yeah. Thank you. Didn't, right? Didn't.
Uh-huh.
Okay, veamos acá. We're gonna make a feedback about this. We get didn't. Okay. La ventaja de didn't es que el verbo lo vamos a dejar en su forma normal. Pero didn't se usa con todos los pronombres. I'm going to use didn't with the old pronouns. Con toditos. Okay. Acá. Didn't es genial porque tenemos que ver que tercera persona. Que... Okay, that's good. It's clear? Yeah, okay, cool. Okay, let's continue with this. And right now we're gonna have an activity, right? And what you're gonna do here? You have to pass this verb or these sentences in the past, right? Using was or were in the simple past. You can use in the negative way if you want. Vamos a pasar estas oraciones al pasado utilizando was it were. Si ustedes quieren hacerlo en negativo, está bien. Así que you're going to have 1 minute. Check it out. Y en 1 minute yo comienzo to ask randomly. Les preguntaré hacia el azar. Así que go ahead. Good luck. 1 minute. 40 seconds. Okay, I'm just kidding. 1 minute, go ahead. Okay, you got it right. Yeah, okay, here we go. Because of the time, we're gonna run quickly, right? And we're gonna start with the first one. Who wants to start? A volunteer. Recuérdense que la primera siempre es la más fácil, así que go ahead, Daisy. Yeah.
I am satisfied with my laptop.
The past tense.
I am not satisfied with my laptop.
Okay, okay. Okay, repeat it again, please. Repeat it, please.
I am satisfied I am satisfied with my laptop.
Okay, in the past tense.
I was
satisfied. Okay. Ok, Daisy, vamos a quitar el am cuando hablamos de pasado.
I was.
Yeah.
Satisfied with my laptop.
Yeah, really good. Congratulations. Cool. ¿Por qué no vamos a dejar am ni los demás que siguen? Porque este el verbo to be es el mismo, pero en pasado, was or were. Si no tiene el verbo to be, tienen que pasar el verbo a. Pasado, según sea el tipo de verbo, si agregamos ed o lo cambiamos totalmente. Todos los verbos que están acá ya los vimos, así que no va a haber problemas. Ok, number two. Who wants to do it? Ok, number two. Who wants to try it?
Right.
Ok, Carlos René, go ahead.
Marta didn't write a letter to her boss.
Okay, yeah, sure, Carlos. Magnífica jugada ahí. Si lo negamos, no tenemos que modificar este verbo. Así que me llega, Carlos. Really good. Thank you.
Okay, teacher.
Okay, si fuese positivo, aquí hubiésemos cambiado write to a wrote.
Wrote.
Yeah, but okay, not. Okay. We're going to jump number three. Who wants to do it?
Okay.
A volunteer there.
Teacher.
Okay, go ahead, William. Thank you.
Creo que está bien así. We were so happy with the food service.
Yeah. Nice. Congratulations, William. Really good. Number two is really good. We were. Okay, number four.
Hi, teacher.
Okay, go ahead, Carlos Alfonso.
Pedro and me drive to the company. In past is Pedro and me drove to the company.
Yeah, sure. Really good. Nice. Congratulations. That's I'm gonna change drive to drove, right? Thank you, Carlos. Really good. Okay, number five. Number five. You can do it. Don't worry. We're gonna make mistake. That's normal.
Teacher.
Yeah.
No sé si estará bien. The principal was sent many emails.
Many emails.
Many emails.
Okay, okay, Carlos. Acá was es un verbo y send es otro verbo. Entonces estamos en pasado simple, así que no podría ser, Carlos. Aquí tendríamos que cambiar este a pasado o tendríamos que negarlo con did not. Vamos otra vez.
Did not many emails.
Ok, pero si pone did not, sí tiene que dejar el...
Tengo que cambiar el...
Tiene que dejar el verbo tal cual está. Solo la S le vamos a quitar. Ok, vamos otra vez.
The principal did not send many emails.
Yeah, sure, really good. Thank you, Carlos Mejia. Nice. Cool. The last one. Okay, the last one. Who wants to do it?
Teacher.
Gentlemen, go ahead, Jorge.
The program wasn't too slow.
Okay, yeah, really nice. Was, right? Because we are talking about the verb be, that will be was or was not. Thank you, Jorge. Really good. Okay, students, basically, right now I can see that you understand how to use the past simple tense with was and were. Okay, we're gonna continue with this. We're gonna have a little problem with did in the past simple tense. So that's why we're gonna see a couple of examples. Vamos a ver un par de ejemplos para aclarar este did, porque a veces nos tiende a confundir. Veamos, did as an auxiliary se ocupa para dos cosas. Para una.
Question.
Yeah. Y para.
Negación.
Yeah, cool. Entonces, como questions, ¿qué significa?
Nada.
Nada, really. Nada. Significa nada, así que. No vayamos a estar traduciendo did, sino que nos va a decir que es una pregunta. Ok, como por ejemplo, tenemos acá this example, right? Ok, let me see, Tatiana, read the example, please, the questions.
Did you go to work yesterday?
Ok, yeah, really good. This is a question, right?
Tú fuiste al... Fuiste al trabajo ayer.
Okay. This is a thank you. Okay, thank you, Tatiana. Really good. Este es fuiste al trabajo ayer. Es una pregunta. Entonces, in this case, si ustedes notan, pasa lo mismo que con didn't, pero como es pregunta, el verbo no cambia, se queda en su forma original. ¿Sí? Okay. ¿Se comprende este uso de did in questions? More or less. Yes. Okay. Okay, cool. Yeah, sure. Okay, so the matter dice, yeah, teacher, I understand, right? Okay. Okay, veamos ahí. Did no significa nada cuando estamos hablando de pregunta, nada más que nos va a decir que es una question. El verbo tiene que quedar en su forma original. Por ejemplo, nos decía Tatiana, did you go to work yesterday? ¿Fuiste a trabajar ayer? Puedo preguntarle, por ejemplo, a Fernando. Fernando, did you work to work yesterday?
Yes, teacher.
Ah, por eso fue que no llegó ahí a la clase, right?
Correct.
Okay, that's good. But it's happened the same, right? With the auxiliary. We're gonna have in the negative way. Para negar algo en inglés que no tenga un verbo to be, por eso es un auxiliar. Porque va a estar cuando no está el verbo to be. Entonces, vamos a poner didn't. Ahí sí significa algo, pero niega el verbo en pasado. Por ejemplo, veamos acá. Mary, can you help me to read it, please?
I didn't go to work yesterday.
Yeah, in the meaning in Spanish, please.
Yo no fui al trabajo ayer.
Okay, que es mentira, pero me imagino que sí. Oye, okay.
Yes.
Entonces acá, si ustedes notan, el verbo queda en su forma original, porque estamos negando con didn't. Es un auxiliar. Didn't go. Entonces, para decir algo en el pasado, en negación es fácil porque solo ponemos didn't. Si es una pregunta, solo did al inicio. Cambia de posición. ¿Ya? Yeah. Ese es como auxiliary. It's clear?
Yes.
Yeah. Questions?
Yes, teacher. Yesterday es correcto poner con A o se puede de la otra forma.
Ajá. Okay, yesterday. Okay. Let me see.
Incorrect.
Yeah, yeah, sure. Ahí, Tatiana, how do you write it? ¿Cómo lo escribe? Yesterday, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, yesterday. Sure. Okay, Tatiana, what's happened here is que yo soy un poco especial para escribir English, right? Mm-hmm. Y a veces las pongo así para ver si ponen atención. Okay.
Desde ayer me estaba preguntando lo mismo.
Yeah, thank you, Tatiana. Ahí se me fue la A con el, la excusa más ideal es que la slide presentation me corrige, me autocorrige. Entonces, a veces me pone una A, a veces me pone otra cosa. Ahí. Okay, but thank you, Tatiana. Esos son los buenos estudiantes. I like it. Estamos
sure.
Con... es parte del ejercicio. Okay,
question. Yeah. Cuando una pregunta es con did, la respuesta siempre es con didn't.
Yeah, sure. Es lo ideal, Marvin. Porque si alguien le dice, did you go to work yesterday? Y usted sí fue, yes, I did. Es una respuesta corta.
Corta.
Si usted quiere agregar más. Yes, okay. I did. And I felt, stressful. Y me sentí así como estresado, por ejemplo, y sigue agregando más cosas. Pero es opcional. ¿Sí? Uh-huh. Ok, pero lo ideal es, yes, I did, no, I didn't. Right? Ok. Ok, nice. We're going to continue with this because of the time right now. We got did as a verb. Como verbo, did significa en presente do, hacer. En pasado sería...
Hice.
Muy bien. Really good. For example, let's see. We get a couple of examples here. Let me see. Okay. Let me see. Miguel, can you help me to read it, please?
Okay. I did something yesterday.
Okay. Really good. What does it mean here? Ok, yeah, hice algo ayer. Entonces acá está actuando como verbo. Él solito sí significa algo porque es un verbo en el pasado. Ya, yeah. Veamos otro ejemplo.
Yeah.
Ok, Rodrigo, go ahead.
I did my homework last week.
Ok, can you translate it into Spanish, please?
Yo hice mi tarea la semana pasada.
Yeah, really good. Entonces acá este did sí tiene un significado que es hice, right? Porque aquí está actuando como verbo. Entonces, did, you can use it like an auxiliary or like a verb. Se puede usar como auxiliar o como verbo. Como auxiliar va a ser cuando sea una question o en negative way. Y en ese caso sería como un verbo, una acción. I did this, I did that, and so on, right? Okay, everything is clear with this?
Yeah. Okay, I have a question.
Tell me, Jorge.
Cuando usamos el verbo do en pasado, pero lo pongo como una negación.
Okay.
I didn't do something yesterday. Así sería.
Yeah, really good. Thank you, Jorge. Jorge nos hizo una pregunta muy genial. No lo había pensado, pero está muy bien, Jorge. Como él lo dijo, es lo correcto. Veamos. Tenemos did like a verb, right? Did como un verbo, pero lo queremos negar. Por ejemplo, yo no hice la tarea ayer. Un ejemplo. Sería, como nos decía Jorge acá, I didn't do the homework. Lo demás. Okay. I didn't do the homework. Acá sí. Lo vamos a poner dos veces. Este porque está siendo un auxiliar en negativo. Y este porque es el verbo que vamos a agregar. Right? Yeah. Cool. It's clear?
Yes, teacher.
Okay, will you get more questions? No? Yes? Okay. Okay, if you don't have any more questions, we're going to continue because we got a lot of activity for today's class. And we got the yes, no question and short answer. As you were asking before, me estaban preguntando esto, Marvin, así que aquí está, vamos a explicar un poquito de esto. Tenemos yes, no questions. Estas yes, no questions son bien famosas porque es cuando nosotros no queremos dar una gran explicación, sino que algo preciso y rápido. For example, we get a couple of questions here. I'm going to give you 1 minute. Les voy a dar 1 minuto para que ustedes vean las questions y las posibles respuestas, positivas y negativas. Véanlas, analícenlas. Si no entienden una palabra, me la dicen. If you don't understand any word, just let me know. I'm going to translate it into Spanish in order to understand this. Okay, here we go. 1 minute. Read it, please. Okay. Okay, really good. I think time is over, right? Okay, we're gonna start with the first one. Si a usted le preguntan con did, responda con did, porque le están haciendo esas questions in the past tense. Le están haciendo esa pregunta en pasado. Si escucha esto con do, es en presente. Tiene que responder con do. Yes, I do. No, I don't. Pero aquí como es did, sería yes, I did. No, I didn't. Ok, we're going to start with this. Imagínense que están en esta situación según esta pregunta. Así que we're going to work in couples. Vamos a trabajar en parejas. Veamos. Wendy and William Alexander. Ok, Wendy, usted le hace la pregunta y William responda según el caso personal. Ok, go ahead, Wendy.
Did you call a mechanic to check your car?
Okay.
No, I didn't.
Okay, really good.
Okay.
Nice, cool. Probably William have a new car, right? Okay. William tiene un carro nuevo, así que por el momento no necesita un mecánico. Pero tal vez cuando sea un mantenimiento, right? Ok, really good. Este, okay. Mechanic. Mechanic. No es mechanic. Mechanic, no mechanic.
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 Okay, cool. Now, let me see. Another couple. Carlos Enrique. This ask these questions to Rodrigo.
Rodrigo, did she pay extra money?
Okay.
Yes, she did.
Yeah, really good, Rodrigo. Nice. Eso es hermoso cuando nos dan extra money, right? Okay, cool. Thank you. Okay, right now we're going to go with, let me see, Marlon, ask this question.
Did we receive a report?
Okay, Daisy, answer these questions. Daisy, did we receive a report? turn on the microphone, please. Okay.
Did we receive the report?
Yeah.
Yes. Yes, we did.
Yeah, really good. Yes, we did, right? Okay, we included in these questions. Really good. Thank you, Daisy. Right now, we're going to continue with, let me see. Carlos René, ask this question to Fabricio. Okay, Carlos René, are you there? Yeah.
Did they sign the letter?
Okay, Fabricio?
Yes, they did.
Yeah, really good, like this, right? Okay, nice. Congratulations. As you see, this okay. is a simple way to answer like a short question, right? Esto es una manera muy fácil de responder esas preguntas. Si usted no se quiere complicar. Si usted quiere dar una explicación, lo hace. But remember that, that English is not the same that in Spanish, right? El inglés no es igual que el español. En español nosotros le preguntamos, por ejemplo, ahí a unas tías que yo tengo por ahí y le preguntamos una cosa y nos cuentan todo lo que pasó en la semana, right? Entonces, en English it happened in the other way around. Son más precisos, solo si hay confianza se dice, pero así es la estructura. Okay, good. We're going to continue with this. And right now, we have to create this question, right? Pero this question, we're going to jump because of the time. Vamos a dejar esto al final. Así que vamos a pasar a this dialogue. And I need to volunteer, Luz y Eva. Veamos. Okay, Daisy wants to be Luz. Okay, who wants to be Eva, right? Este puede ser un gentleman. Ahí le cambiamos el name. Okay, ya tenemos a Luz. Who wants to talk with Daisy? Okay. Okay. Thank you. Let me see. Thank you, Marlon. Marlon, go ahead. Marlon, you will be a Marlon, right? In this way.
Eva.
Okay, teacher.
Okay, go ahead, Daisy. Okay, let's get started with this conversation. Go ahead.
Can you tell me more about your experience?
Yep.
Wasn't so nice because the agent didn't give me a confirmation number. He didn't even send a receipt for what I bought.
Okay.
Do you remember the again name? Pardon, the agent's name?
Yep.
No, I don't actually. I think he didn't say his name. It wasn't keen.
My apologies for that. And what about our products? Because you send it. You send it.
Okay.
Yes, I called. It wasn't so easy, but I called another again. He was so considerate. His name was Romeo, and he explained everything to me.
Okay, thank you. Really good work. Okay, thank you so much, guys. Really nice. Okay, we're gonna try to make a feedback about some pronunciation of this word. Así que please pay full attention to this. You can say this word experience. Experience.
Experience.
Yeah, sure. And this one, yeah, sure. Boat. Agent's name.
Agent's name.
Okay, this one is kind. kind.
Kind.
Okay, this one, apologize.
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 Yeah. Could you use it? Could you use it?
Could you use it?
Could you use it? Yes.
Could you use it?
Called.
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 Called you.
With E at the end. Called.
Called.
Called. Called.
Yeah. Consider it.
Consider it.
Consider it.
Yeah. And explain.
Explain.
Explain it.
Yeah, sure. Okay, really good. I need a couple to continue practice this dialogue, please. Raise your hand. Who wants to practice? The more you practice, the more you learn, right?
Hi, teacher.
Okay, thank you, Wendy.
Mm-hmm. Wendy. Me, teacher.
Okay, Wendy and?
Me.
Okay. Who said me? Jose Angel Santos. Okay, go ahead. Okay, entonces Wendy will be Luz and Jose Angel Santos will be Eva, right? Go ahead.
Okay. Can you tell me more about your experience?
Okay. Okay, Jose. Okay, Jose Angel, I think he got a little problem with the internet connection or something like that. Okay.
It's once, so the agent is.
Okay, Jose Angel is moving to another place. I hope we can do it right now. Okay, what about right now, Jose? Go ahead.
It was so nice because the agent did give me a confirmation number that didn't even send for what I
want. Okay, go ahead, Wendy.
Do you remember the agent's name?
No, I don't actually. In the, he didn't say his name. He wants ID. He wants kind, pardon. Kind.
My apologies for that. And what about or the product called Cool Juice? Use it.
Okay.
Yes, I called. I want so Ace, but I considered his name was Romeo and he explained everything to me.
Okay, yeah, really good. Nice. Thank you, guys. Okay, let's see. Jose Santos, no sé si era el problema con el internet, pero le ayudó mucho ahí. Se escuchaba muy rápido en su vida. Okay, nice. Thank you, Jose. Right now, apologize.
Okay.
Apologize. Kind. Apologize, kind. Remember this. Apologize, kind. Right? Cold. Okay, I need a couple more, please. One more couple. Go ahead. Who wants to practice again? Okay. Gabriela, ready?
Okay.
Okay, really good. Gabriela, who wants to practice with Gabriela? Ah, I know. Rodrigo. Go ahead, Rodrigo.
Okay. ¿Quién soy?
I start.
Okay.
¿Quién soy?
Okay, Gabriela, you will be Eva, right?
Okay.
And you will be Rodrigo, the first one.
Okay. Can you tell me more about your experience?
because the agent didn't give me a confirmation number. He didn't even send a reply for what about boat.
Yes.
Did you remember the agent's name?
No, I don't actually. I think he didn't say his name. He wasn't kind.
I apologize for that. And what about your our product? Could you see it? Could you use it?
Yes, I could. It wasn't so easy, but I called it another agent again. He was so considerate. His name was Romero, and he explained everything to me.
Okay, thank you. Really, really good. Nice. Congratulations. All of these you pronounce in a really good way. Cold.
Cold.
Yeah, good.
Cold.
Nice. Everything is okay. I like it. Okay. Unfortunately, because of the time, we're going to jump this activity. And right now, what we're going to do? We're going to work in groups, right? As you do all the time. But you have to create your own conversation, right? Asking to a customer at the last service, what you got it with your company. And you have to ask questions in a simple way, yes, no questions, to know if everything was provided. What you're gonna do here? Necesito que creen una conversación en el past tense, que incluyan un saludo, hey, hello, how are you? Did you receive the products, for example? Yes, I did, pero me salió malo, bla, 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 y comenzamos, yeah, cool. Necesito que hagan las preguntas como lo vimos anteriormente. Pueden basarse en esta conversación, si no lo pueden hacer más pequeño o más grande, whatever you want. Así que I need a conversation, right? Questions, right? Okay, it's clear? Yeah, sure. Okay, go ahead. We're gonna work in groups, and right now we're gonna work like this. Okay, here we go. Good luck. Try to practice each other. Go ahead. If you have questions, I'm gonna be there, right? Okay. Daisy, did you go to the groups? Okay, I think we got a problem with the internet connections. So we're going to wait for a while for her. Right. Okay, Daisy. Hello, Daisy.
Hola, teacher.
Acepte la solicitud para entrar al grupo, Daisy.
Oh, sorry, teacher. Describí el chat.
Okay, I'm gonna move to the group. Okay, let's see, ahí estamos, Daisy.
No, okay.
Yeah. Okay, hello, Marvin.
Teacher, tuve problema ahí con el internet, me desconecté.
Okay, I'm going to assign you to another group. Okay, go ahead.
Thank you, teacher.
Okay, you're welcome.
Ah, podemos hacer una pregunta y digamos, por ejemplo, yo puedo decir, in my opinion, my experience, bla, 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 bla. Y luego que Fabricio dé su opinión.
Como que esté hablando con dos personas.
Ajá.
O sea, una llamada de dos personas.
Sí, una videoconferencia.
Una conferencia.
Hagámoslo así, démoslo.
Okay,
that will be a video call.
Yeah.
Muy bien, pero no sé qué decir.
Okay, continue working. I'm gonna go to another group. Ahí así no les va a dar pena, right? Okay.
Okay. Bye bye. Okay,
bye. Está fallando como está lloviendo.
Ajá, a mí también. Se queda hasta mudo.
Sí. Vaya. Hi. My name is... Ops. Estoy escribiendo. Y ahí mencionamos el nombre cada quien, ¿verdad?
Bueno, en este caso, como digamos, yo sería el que le está preguntando sobre el producto.
Ah, ¿verdad? Tendría que...
Sería mi nombre. Hi, my name is William. How are you? Okay. Y les empiezo a preguntar qué les ha parecido el celular.
Ok, ok. But you guys, I'm gonna create a conversation simulando que es una
llamada.
Ok, ok. In this case, William, you can say, hello, William is speaking. Hello, William is speaking. Or you can say, hello, this is William.
This is William.
This is William. This.
This. T-H-I-S.
Ahí, así es como
está
ahorita.
Is.
Luego is, yeah.
Is, ajá.
Está un poco lento mi internet.
Okay, no problem, it's okay. Ok.
De allí, ¿qué pregunta era, William?
Espérame, te la voy a hacer.
Ahí se ve.
Vaya, ahorita. Ahí.
Ahí, ajá.
Vaya, esa es la conversación. En base a esa conversación, ya me van a ver todos los chats, qué pena.
No, yo puse la pantallita ahí donde están los chats.
¡Ey, qué malo!
I saw the chat. Your mom chat.
Ahí está. Hoy sí la ves.
Did you cook?
Yeah. Yes. My professional is pastry.
Ok, teacher, ya tenemos la conversación, ¿ya vio? Excelente.
Really?
Usando deep.
It's look similar to the ones before, right?
Yes.
Se parece mucho a la que acabamos de ver.
Ahorita la estamos haciendo, el la conversación.
Okay. Okay, really good. No problem. Mm-hmm. Okay, go ahead, continue practice. Do you need help?
No.
Okay, good.
No.
Okay. Thank you. I'm gonna be back in a minute.
Okay.
O de algún evento en el pasado.
Okay.
Alguna fiesta o algo así.
With the party, podemos ocupar así como with the party.
Yeah, sure.
With the party with us.
Sí, que estuvo bien o mal. Yes. De hablar de la comida o algo así.
Ajá, podemos hacer algo así como I like it, but I.
Ajá.
I don't feel interesting. I feel interesting. Yeah, interesting.
algo así como lo que estaba, pero no era interesante.
Mm-hmm.
But no interest.
Omitimos lo del producto y hablamos mejor de la pregunta.
Yeah.
Ajá.
Que
podría ser así como the reason the call is no the level of satisfaction that you have with the party with us. Y algo así como, okay, it's fine, but I'm not interested. It was fine. Sería como el verbo was. It was no was fine. Sin el is. Sino que sería como, okay, was fine, but no interest.
Okay.
En vez de fine, podemos ser great. Great, ajá.
También.
También.
Uh-huh. Puede poner sí, ahora tengo... Sí, tengo 5 minutos. Sí, podría ayudarle si son 5 minutos. O si es un tiempo corto, no sé cómo redactar ahí.
Yes, I have a 5 minutes.
Okay. Okay, Jorge, ahí solo está bien, solo que quitemos el A. I have 5 minutes.
Okay, fine, okay. Yes. Okay. ¿Alguna pregunta ahí?
Okay, questions. It could be like, did you like our service? It could be, right?
Podríamos preguntarle ahí, ¿cómo evalúa la velocidad de su internet?
Yeah, sure.
Okay. How?
Yeah. How would you? Creo que sí me decía.
How
good. WOULD.
Yep.
¿Cómo fue?
WOULD. Oh. No, está bien. How good.
Ah,
ajá.
¿Cómo podría ascender a la vida? ¿A la
wood? Ah, espacio. Yo.
Pero el wood. ¿No qué es lo que significa el ira? Ira, digamos, cuando lo explicaron. Pero yo no me acuerdo si se utilizaba también en preguntas.
How would you like? Okay, in this case, you have to ask the question in the past simple tense. You can use was or were. How was your experience or how did you evaluate our speed connection, for example?
Okay. How was el día siempre?
Yeah, how was or how did, whatever.
How was,
your experience?
Why? Your experience.
Yeah. Y ahí agregan los demás. ¿Cómo fue su experiencia con esto o con no? Yeah. Okay.
Okay. Thank you, teacher.
Hey, welcome.
¿Cómo me dijiste, Carlos Alfonso?
Se veía con la velocidad, sería este, experience with. De sería the speed of your internet.
Speed of, as speed of your internet, sí. O si quieres escribir, si quieres escribirlo tú, te voy a compartir cómo se llama, te va a pasar el control.
Ah, no, okay. Sí, está bien. Solo es your internet. Solo que te haga la R.
Ok, internet.
Your...
No, que es que la R es para decir de tú, no es you, es suyo, de su internet, como decíamos, tu internet.
Mm-hmm. Ya. Yeah.
Por eso le estoy poniendo el your con la R.
Yeah, sure. It's okay with your.
Uh-huh.
How was your experience with the speed of your internet connection?
Aquí, el off, sino no. The speed of connection.
Ahí could be like this. How was your experience with internet connections. Entendemos que es speed.
Okay, internet connection. Connection. Ahí sí no sé cómo se escribe.
Yeah, okay. ION connections.
I open connection, así.
Yeah, connections. It's missing a C before T.
Okay, me confundí, no entendí.
Lleva después de la E, lleva una C.
Después de la E,
connection, okay.
Connection,
uh-huh. Ah, okay.
Okay, really good.
Okay. Vaya, Carlos Enrique, ¿cuál fue tu experiencia con tu conexión de internet?
Okay.
Por lo general está bien, pero...
Y sal. Ah.
pero cuando llueve, es mala la internet.
Okay. Vaya, en inglés, ¿cómo se diría? Progenery.
Generalmente,
bueno.
Ok. The connection.
Yeah. Ok, remember that you are asking with was. Te están preguntando con el was.
Okay.
Así que van a responder algo del pasado.
Pueden ok.
Responder Carlos, de la semana pasada. Por ejemplo, él en su mente dice, esta semana estuvo buena la señal. This week, lo demás, was, y luego si él quiere agregar, but sometimes, pero algunas veces, pasa esto y esto y esto. Ahí.
Ahí me quedo. Vale. Si quieren, ah, compañeros, les puedo pasar el control para que lo escriban ustedes.
Ok.
Démosle.
Vaya, okay. No sé quién lo va a escribir. ¿Carlos Enrique o Carlos Alfonso?
Si querés lo escribo, voy a tratar de escribirlo yo ahí.
Vaya, pues. Vaya, te pasé. Creo que te va a tener que salir una opción para que tomes el control. Ahí está.
Okay.
This week. No sé si estaría bien así.
Dale, que aquí estamos aprendiendo.
Yeah, sure. You're learning. Don't worry.
Okay.
Yeah, really good. You can put a comma. Yeah. And then you can add lo que dijo este Carlos Enrique, it was good last week, but, pero, but sometimes,
sometimes
I had a problem. I had a problem. Yeah, good. Really good. Y ahí siguen, siguen agregando. Okay, nice. Thank you. I'm gonna go to another group.
Okay. See you. Thank you, teacher.
Okay, you're welcome.
Call. Okay, intento de conversations.
Okay, yeah. We are learning, don't worry.
Teacher, usually they call you, how was your experience in your trip?
You?
No.
Okay, ahí. you can do it like that, but it's missing something. Se puede decir, pero hace falta algo. Por ejemplo, could you share? Could you share? ¿Podrías compartirnos? Could you share us?
Sure.
A B C.
Hey, yeah. Qué malo.
R E. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Could you share us a nosotros, verdad? U S. U S. No, you.
Ah.
You, the other one. like this. Okay, let me see. Like this, you.
You.
Yeah. By you. La U.
Ah, la U. Es que no le veo bien la mano.
Está un poco palda, okay.
Yo dije, dinero, dije yo.
Okay, no, yo haciendo el esfuerzo así. Okay,
ah, yo quiero dinero.
Eso. Okay, S. Yeah, can you share us? Coma y luego la pregunta. Ahí sí. Ah, ¿podrías compartirnos? ¿Cómo fue tu experiencia en tu viaje? Yeah, really okay. Good. This.
Fernando, ¿qué me va a contestar?
Is want. Solo son de nuevo.
¿Qué tú pasas?
It was not.
It was.
Uh-huh.
Was it not or was?
Was not.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. To our place because have problem with the transport.
Así te escuché. No sé si estaba bien.
No. Quise decir, it was not.
Mm-hmm.
Ay, ya no me acuerdo que te. I was not.
Our place. Uh-huh. O-U-R. O.
O.
Así hoy sí. U.
Ah, ok.
R. And then space y luego place. Singular.
Ah. De
place. P-L-A-C-E. Was in our place without D, sin el DHE. Ese lo borramos.
It was our place because had problem with the transport.
Because.
Porque tuve problemas con el transporte. Because.
Problem.
With the transport.
¿Cómo se escribe transporte, teacher?
Transport.
Con N, trans.
Yeah. Se escucha raro, pero así se dice transport.
Transport. La S. No sé el teacher ahí con su...
Ahí. Vamos a aprender el lenguaje de los...
De las señas, de los sordos.
Yeah, it's really useful. Okay, uh-huh. In this case, Wendy, solo aquí donde dice because.
El signo de admiración.
No. It's missing the personal pronouns. Porque yo tuve un problema o nosotros tuvimos un problema.
Because.
Replace you because sería.
Otra. Because. No sería. Because I have. Porque yo lo tuve. I have problem with the transport.
The transport. Okay.
Yeah, sure. Really good.
Do you remember? Do you remember the numbers? The fly. In español, yo creo.
Okay, very good. You're gonna have 5 minutes more, 5 minutitos más, y ahí le damos con with the conversations. Okay, thank you.
Okay. ¿Tú recuerdas el número de vuelo?
Yes, I do.
Okay.
Okay, but in this case, Wendy, did you remember?
Did you? Perfect.
Yeah, did you remember?
Arriba.
Okay. And Fernando, yes, I did.
Yes, I did, Es que como me dijo tú.
Yeah, I know. Son bien obedientes ahí. Me dijo tú, yo le contesté con tú.
Pues sí, usted dijo. Yeah. Conteste según las preguntas, dijo usted.
Yeah, sure. You have to answer like this. Okay, cool.
Es que para ver si no está poniendo atención, como dijiste.
Okay. Ya es parte ahí de the activity.
Right? Teacher, le quito un segundo. Ya terminé la lo que debía de la semana pasada.
Okay, I'm gonna check it out today.
Igual yo lo contesté, pero cuando uno escribe todo sale malo.
Okay. Sometimes sale malo. Por las cosas que escribí en WhatsApp. Tenemos que poner todo en mayúsculas. Algunas veces el acento que ponemos es un... El apóstrofe, perdón, es un acento. Si no nos funciona, a veces hay que copiar la palabra de la plataforma.
Así es.
Pero lo reporté y ya lo solucionaron. Así que no va a haber problema.
Ahí me pone 10 porque mucho cuesta con eso.
Out of 10, don't worry. Okay.
Dios guarde.
Okay.
Vaya.
Okay. Hi, teacher.
Hello, you got it right. Did you finish?
Finish.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay. Okay, if you finish, I would like to hear you. Go ahead.
Okay, teacher.
Comienza.
William y Tatiana.
Okay.
Hello, this is William. How are you?
I'm fine.
Did you like the cell phone?
Yes, I did. It worked perfectly for me.
Okay.
You do not want to buy another cell phone?
Yesterday I said one that I like.
I have a new model. Would you like to see it?
Of course.
Thanks.
I see you tomorrow.
Okay, okay. Really good. Yeah, ya vendieron otro teléfono, right? Okay, that's good. Todo está muy bien. Me gusta. Really good. Solo acá en donde dice work. Yes, I did. It's worked perfectly for me. Como acá estamos haciendo referencia que es en pasado, vamos a poner una ED. ED.
ED.
Working.
Yeah,
working.
ED.
ED, yes.
¿Es una E?
ED.
Yeah. But in English, you're going to say ED.
ED.
Ahí se dice worked. Worked.
Worked.
Yeah. Word. Okay, and let me see this one. Donde dice yesterday, I saw. Yep.
I saw.
No, así está bien, así como lo han puesto. Pero se dice
I saw.
I liked.
Okay, okay, really good. Okay, now I would like to hear Marvin and your partner. Go ahead.
Okay, Tatiana me pregunta.
Hello, this is Tatiana. How are you?
I'm fine.
Did you like the cell phone?
Yes, I did. It worked perfectly for me.
You do not want to buy another cell phone?
Yesterday I saw one that I liked.
I have a new model. Would you like to see it?
Of course. Vaya. Hoy le voy a preguntar yo a William.
Okay, okay.
Okay.
Hello, this is Marvin. How are you?
I'm fine.
Did you like the cell phone?
Yes, I did. It worked perfectly for me.
You don't want to buy another cell phone?
Yesterday I saw one that I liked.
I have a new model. Would you like to see it?
Of course.
Okay, really good. Nice. Tomorrow you're gonna see this cell phone, right? Okay.
Yes, okay.
Yeah. That's good. Amazing. You did a really great job. Thank you, guys. If you can continue practice, it's gonna be good. Thank you so much. I see you in a minute.
Thank you.
Okay, bye.
Sí, sí, sí. Como siempre. Ay, bien, el dicho.
All right.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, did you finish?
Yeah. Yes.
Pero tenemos una pregunta. Aquí, prefer. To prefer us, está bien.
Okay, great, thanks. For us. Yes, it's okay. It's okay. Yeah.
Oh.
Okay.
Bye. Empezamos.
Okay.
Hi, I call you for ask you some question about your experience with our mechanic service. How was it?
In my case, I have a bad experience because when I went there, it was full, and they waited about 2 hours to check my car.
I'm so sorry to hear that. I don't know what happened. But don't worry, we are going to give you discount in your next service.
Thanks, sir.
Gabriela, what about you?
In my case, I didn't have any problem. The mechanic fixed my car and I paid less than the last time because you had offers.
Great. Thanks to referrals.
Okay, really good, amazing. That's nice. I like it. Okay, really nice work, students. Gabriela, you know, got the most difficult part. Okay, that's amazing. I really like when you speak because you are really fluently, and that's great. Okay, cool. If you can continue practice, or talk about your job, it's okay, but in English, right? Okay.
I'm okay. Gonna talk.
I'm gonna go to another group. Thank you so much. Okay.
Okay, teacher.
Hello.
I wish.
You finish?
Ya casi.
Okay. Okay.
Hoy sí me he acostado. Vaya, sí. Está bien. Acá sería, you can remember the company you will we fly with.
Hey, ya faltan cuatro.
Ok.
No nos llegó la tarde otra vez.
Sí, yeah, sure. Ok, you finish, guys.
Yes.
Yes, teacher. Hasta ahí llegamos.
Ok, go ahead.
Le vamos a preguntar, teacher, en la última línea del cliente, yep. Si está bien así, poner was it rain al final o es when it was rain.
When it was, yes, when it was rain, in the other way around.
No, penúltimo. Solo era quitarle was.
No, el was está bien.
Solo
cerca el trick era.
Yeah, sure.
Okay.
Yeah, go ahead.
Okay. Hello, my name is Jorge de Oxmovis El Salvador. I speak with Carlos.
Yes, I am Carlos.
Nice, Carlos. May you ask some questions for your experience with our internet service?
Yes, I have 5 minutes.
How was your experience with internet connection?
It was good last week, but sometimes I had a problem.
When do you have the problem?
I had the problem when it was raining.
My apologies for that. Always happens in heavier rain.
Okay, yeah, really good. Cool, I like it. Okay, right now you're gonna practice with Carlos Enrique.
Hello, my name is Carlos of Movistar, El Salvador. I speak with Carlos.
Yes, I am Carlos.
Carlos. Nice, Carlos. May you answer some question for your experience with our internet service?
Yes, I have 5 minutes.
What's your experience with internet connection?
It was good last week, but sometimes I had a problem.
When did you have the problem?
I had the problem when it was raining.
My apologies for that. Always happens in heavy rain.
Okay, really good work, students. Nice, I like your conversation. That's amazing. Okay, I'm gonna go to the last group and then we're gonna go back to the main session, right? Thank you so much.
Hey, thank you, teacher.
Thank you, teacher.
Hey, welcome.
Music sería, tendría que ser good music.
Okay, hello. Did you finish, right?
Uh-huh. Didn't because how good music. No tenía buena música.
Ajá. Uh-huh.
Okay, you finish.
Yeah.
Okay, go ahead. I would like to hear you, right?
Okay, I'm beginning again. Good morning. I am Miguel from Cetron. I am speaking to Carlos.
Good morning. He's speaking.
The reason of the call is to know the level of satisfaction that you have with the party with us.
Okay, all right, but not interesting.
Why did you enjoy it?
Not even because how got good music.
Did you recommend or party with your friends?
No, I didn't recommend.
Okay, fine.
Okay.
Bye.
Okay, really good, nice, I like it. That sound naturally, that's okay, I really like. Thank you, guys. That's amazing for your work, right? I'm going to go to the last group, and then we're going to return to the main session. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Okay, let me see. Yeah, sure. Okay. Hello, hello. Did you finish, right?
Vaya, Fernando. Empecemos.
Okay, okay, okay.
Could you share with how was as well, has who was your experience in your trip?
It was not our play because I had problem with the transport.
Do you remember number the flight?
Yes, I did.
You can remember the company you would fly with?
Yes, I remember company was Avianca.
Okay, we'll change your flight.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you, really good, nice, cool. I like it. That was nice, amazing.
Costó, pero ahí estamos.
10, okay. Teacher, 10 or 0.
Yeah, yeah, no, you get a 10, right?
Okay. In grammar, 0.
Yeah, thank in you. Grammar, you get a 9. Ahí donde dice, okay, we'll change your flight. I will change.
Okay.
Okay, what about Marlon?
Hello, Marlon. Teacher. Y andaba comprando las pupusas.
Okay.
Pero no invitaste a Marlon.
Yeah, you're right.
ya me las comí, hacía la carrera, me las comí.
Okay.
Como hoy no, teacher, siempre vamos a tener ahora la asesoría. Yeah, sure.
Sí, siempre vamos a tener, así que vamos a regresar a la sesión principal.
Okay.
Yeah, see you there, right? Okay, hello, hello. Thanks for being here, guys. All the time we, you know, we're gonna meet like a death, right? Les robamos un poquito de su tiempo ahí. Yo sé que ahorita estuvieran ahí en Free Fire, Netflix, I don't know where. But I'm going to pass the attendance list again. Carlos Enrique Martínez Genoves.
Present, teacher.
Yeah, really good. José Ángel Santos Martínez. José Ángel. Okay, I think Jose Angel got a problem with the internet connections. Ahí nos escribió en el chat. Está lloviendo muy fuerte, así que Rodrigo Alexander Maravilla Vázquez.
Presente, teacher.
Okay, really good, Rodrigo. Nice, congratulations. Unfortunately, guys, time is over for today's class. I don't know if you have questions. No questions. Okay, if you don't have any questions, it's a pleasure to see you today. And I'll see you for the ones who try to speak with me 1 hour, right, later on, from 10 to, okay, I'll see you there, and the rest of you, I'll see you tomorrow. Bye-bye, take care.
Bye.
Bye.
See you tomorrow. Bye.
See you tomorrow.
Good night.
Good night. Una pregunta, teacher.
Yeah, tell me.
Lo que tenemos ahora, la reunión, no sé cómo se, o sea, nunca me he unido, ni sé cómo es, cómo se une.
Ok, ese es un link aparte, Rodrigo. Si gusta, se lo voy a compartir ahí.
Ajá, por favor, que no tengo nada ahorita para unirme.
Ok, that's good. I will do it right now in a moment.
Ok, gracias, teacher.
Ok, welcome.